I have a thing that takes me about 5 seconds, and I do it a couple times a week. I know what I should do. I should spend 3 hours trying to automate it.
Hi guys, welcome in another video. This video will be part of the series in which I will show you how to create very simple Android Studio plugin, which toggles the show layout bands option, the option from developer options that you all probably know and use. I wanted to do this plugin for quite some time because it really is a thing that I use quite a lot, and it really annoys me that I have to search for it in settings every time. So I realized that it's a great opportunity to learn how to do Android Studio plugin and to show it to you and to show you that it's not really that hard. In the first part of the series, you will learn how to create a very simple Android Studio plugin which shows a notification and how to get a list of connected devices from the ADB. In the second video, you will learn how to show and hide layout bounds using ADB shell script and how to run the script from the Android Studio plugin. So, without further ado, let's start coding.
Okay, so the first thing that we need is to download IntelliJ IDE. And really important thing here, the version of your IntelliJ have to have the same IntelliJ platform version as used in Android Studio. We can find the version of IntelliJ platform used to build Android Studio in about dialog screen. And as you can see, it's displayed here, and in my case, it starts with 201. So on IntelliJ download page, I don't download the latest version of the IDE, but go to the versions page and look for a build which starts with 201. And here it is, exactly the same number that was used to build my version of Android Studio. But if the version that you found starts with the same prefix but does not match perfectly, you can use this dropdown to look for a specific fixed version to match build versions perfectly.
Okay, so I have IntelliJ installed, and as you can see in About dialog, my build version matches exactly the build version we saw in Android Studio.
So now we can create a new project. In the wizard, we select IntelliJ Platform Plugin option and Kotlin JVM because obviously we want to use Kotlin. Then hit Next, and on the next screen, specify the name and location of a project. After we clicked Finish, a new project is created, and as you can see, it contains build Gradle file and plugin.xml file. In this file, we will specify all information about our plugin and register actions. Okay, so we will first focus on build Gradle file. The first thing that we need to do is to specify that our plugin is Android Studio plugin and uses the API from Android plugin. And to do it, we set the IntelliJ plugin attribute to Android. The second thing that we need to do is to specify the directory where Android Studio is located, and we do it using run IDE ID directory attribute. And since I won't be publishing this plugin outside my local machine, I will just hard code path to my Android Studio just for simplicity's sake. After all this, we can synchronize our Gradle and move to the next step, which is creating a new action. To create an action, we need to create a new Kotlin class, and we'll call this class show layout bounds. In this class, we will specify all logic that will be triggered once our action is triggered. And to make our class an action, we have to inherit from a class an action. The function that we need to implement is action perform, and here we will launch our notification.
And as you can see, this function has one parameter. I will ignore him for now, but we will use him later, just in a second. As you can see, I created show notification function, which takes our message as a parameter, and I defined this function just below.
In this function, I use notification group class to, well, not surprisingly, create notification group. This function takes as a parameter display ID and notification display type, and this type specify if our notification will close by itself or maybe the user has to interact with it to close it. Next, we will use create notification function to, well, create notification and pass our notification title, our message, and the type of the notification. I use notification type warning, which gives me the nice little warning icon next to the notification. And since we don't need it, I also specified listener to null. And the last thing, to launch the notification, I need to call notify, and this function needs project to be passed to it. So I have to pass it also to show notification function. I chose to make the show notification an extension function, and I pass project as a receiver. But if you prefer, you can also pass project as a function parameter. It's completely fine. Now we can register action and specify what will trigger it. We can do it manually in plugins XML file, but we can also use the wizard in IntelliJ. So to do it, we will click register action option and here specify action ID, name and description. Below on a list, we can select where to display our action. As you can see, the list is pretty long and we can, for example, select to display our action in the main menu, as I did here. At the very bottom, we can also optionally specify keyboard shortcut for this action, and once we are done, we can click OK. And now, as you can see, the action was added to plugin XML file. And here is an ID, class, title, and description that we typed. We can, of course, change previously selected options. I decided that I want my action to be displayed in Tools menu instead of Main menu and at the very bottom of the list. I also removed extensions since we don't need them and modified description, name and other information about the plugin, which will be visible once we install the plugin in Android Studio. So now when everything else is done, we can finally build our plugin to create a jar file which will be used to install the plugin in Android Studio. It can take a couple of seconds, and once plugin is built, we can move to Android Studio. And here in Preferences, we go to Plugin section and select Install Plugin from Disk option. The jar that we built will be in the build libs directory in our project. Once we install the plugin, Android Studio may notify you that it needs to restart to apply changes in a plugin. As you can see, this time it was not necessary. And after I installed the plugin, in the Tools section, there is a new option, Show Layout Bounds. And after I click it, it shows a notification that we wrote. I can, of course, also trigger this action using keyboard shortcut that we specified earlier, or search a name of an action. Okay, back to IntelliJ. We have a basic plugin that displays a notification. Now let's add another element. To enable layout bounds option, the first thing that we will need to do is to get a list of connected devices that we want to interact with. And because we want to interact with Android Debug Bridge, which is a part of API from Android plugin, we need to specify JetBrains Android dependency in plugin XML file. After that, we can go back to Show Layout Bounds class to fetch connected devices and display how many devices are connected now. To do it, we will use Android SDK Utils class, then call getDebugBridge function, which takes project as a parameter. From ADB, we can get all connected devices list. And since some fields can be null, we will move things around so the code compiles. Okay, so now the very easy logic, we will just check if the devices list is null or empty. If so, we will display the notification with no devices connected message, and if some devices are connected, we will display how many devices are connected using the notification. And once everything is done, we can build our plugin once more. And then after our project builds, we can go into Android Studio,
install plugin from disk once again, select a new jar, and now as you can see, I have to restart IDE to apply changes in plugin.
Once Android Studio is restarted, I can test the plugin that we created. And as you can see, I have one device connected at the moment, and when I click Show Layout Bounce action, the notification appears with appropriate text, and once I quit an emulator, the notification message changes.
Okay, so we covered all the basics. You learned how to get a list of connected devices and how to display a notification. In the next video, we will finish our plugin. I will show you how to run ADB shell command from Android Studio plugin to finally show, hide, and toggle layout bounce option from our plugin. So stay tuned, we see each other in the next video, which will be available really soon.